When I first got Scampers as a 4-month-old puppy, I could tell right away that we needed help. There was a local obedience class. There was a lot of good things that we learned, but we continually had issues with stays and with recalls. If I tried to go away from the leash very far, he often bolt and play. During recalls, he was as likely to come to me as pass me and go play and do zoomies around the yard. It was very frustrating. Some days, you know, you'd see these dogs, and they were amazing dogs in class. The trainer I went to is a very good, well-known local trainer. And you'd see these amazing dogs, and here you are. You know, your dog doesn't work on a loose leash, let alone off leash. You can't get farther than the end of the leash without him bolting. You know, and he did improve. It still felt like we were missing something. I was still frustrated, and every time we'd do recalls, I'd be like, oh God, let me just hide at the back. I don't want to do a recall. Because you just, you know, you always had that fear that he wasn't going to recall. So at one point, we even tried an e-collar, and all that did is make him scared. We tried toys, we tried food, the food wasn't working, the toys weren't working, and I didn't know why. I didn't know why. And I knew I didn't have the skill set to figure this out on my own. But we wanted to keep him safe. We wanted that recall so that if he's outside on a busy street or if he gets away from me, that I'd have that recall so that he wouldn't get run over by a car. That was the overriding concern of everyone. Because he is a large dog, and he is strong enough that he can pull me off my feet. With my horses, I've always known what foundation was. I knew what to do when things weren't working. But with the dog, I didn't have the skill set to know when things weren't working, how to go back, how to make it simpler. I was afraid to take him out in California without a prong collar because he's a big, strong dog. He's very prey driven. And, you know, I was very afraid he'd get away from me if he saw a small animal. I read a lot of books. I read on both sides of the spectrum with positive and other methods, and I didn't have the skill set. So when I saw recallers come up the second time, I was just so frustrated. I was like, okay, I've got to try this. I don't really know what it is. I don't really know if it's going to help, but we've tried everything else and I've got to try something, something new. It really, really helped to where I had the confidence to take him out on walks. And as our recall improved, so did our walks. I had more skills to bring his attention back to me. The other night, we were in the agility field and my dog was focused. A cat was playing in the fence. And my dog went, cat playing in the fence! And he targeted, and I thought, oh, I might have to put him back in the crate. But I took him aside and I kind of took him away from where he was targeting, and I did some nose touches and got his attention back on me, and I thought, oh, should I do this? Should I do this? This might be a failure. I thought, well, it's just practice, so if it's a failure, next time I'll put him in the crate. I won't try. But he actually did. He did the sequence, and he didn't care about the cat, and after the sequence was done, he came right back to me, and I went, thank God. His attention on me improved in the agility to where we went from him running off and hiding in tunnels to following me around the field and finally being able to compete in novice. And within 3 shows, he had finished his novice. Recallers has helped me learn the little pieces so that I can have a dog that I can go for a loose leash walk, so that I can take him on the bike without a prong collar, so that we can go to agility practice and not have to worry about having a prong collar or anything else. And it's so cool, so cool. So on the inside, there's 40 games, and you can watch the games anywhere. Most of the videos are 10, 15 minutes max. It's games and fun and things that you don't really see in a lot of your normal everyday classes that just make it fun, where you wanna go out and work with your pet, because you're not thinking about going out and working, you're thinking about having this fabulous game. How fun is that? Rather than, oh God, I gotta go. Is he going to run? You just need a small space in your house. For me, because I have a dog that's highly distractible, I want it to start the games in the house where there was less distractions. You want to start the games in a place that's quiet. And for most of us, that's our house. You know, it's not like taking a statistics class where you have to, or a master's class where you have to, you know, plan your weekends out because you've got to allow 8 hours for homework. It's not like that. I really wish I had signed up the first time. I really wish I had. I wish I'd had recallers before I brought him home. I'm so glad that I did sign up for it, and I definitely want to stay in the recallers program. The information that I've learned in recallers, it not only helps scampers, it's going to help any dog I ever have. I don't worry about going places with them. I don't worry about taking them different places. I know that there may still be a failure here and there, but I don't get upset about it. Recallers, you know, gave me those tools to know how to take it back. And her programs in general gave me that knowledge I needed to know when things weren't working, how to go back and to be successful with smaller pieces so that he could be successful. But regardless of which dog I have and what challenge that dog has, whether it's you know, not engaging, whether it's being overly enthusiastic, whether it's being underly enthusiastic, regardless of what that specific dog's challenge is, there's so much foundation in the program that's going to help you with any dog.